Hey everyone, welcome to Brainfruit Build Day 9. Shout out to Sean Plott for those in the know. Today, I'm going to keep rolling on sand and drywall. I got all the high stuff done yesterday, so I'm going to try to get the rest of the way around today and get the final two portable flats painted today as well, and hopefully get to where I can start my second coat of spackle today as well. So I'm gonna finish my coffee, get a little more fresh air in before I gotta breathe in dust for the next half a day, and get started. Thanks for coming back, and I hope you enjoy the video. philosophy that I have about why I think it's beneficial for all people, really, but in particular for creative people to learn how to finish drywall. Spackle, sand, finish, drywall. And the reason is that there's so many lessons that are kind of requisite to creating adequate works of art in whatever field that you create in that are inherently tied to adequately finishing drywall at much less high stakes. So you can learn the lesson without the risk of messing something up that you held such importance in that it deflates your motivation. And so these things are pretty apparent once I point them out. It's like, oh yeah, that makes a lot of sense. I know this sounds like some Mr. Miyagi stuff, but stick with me. Finishing drywall requires that you learn to leave well enough alone. When you're spackling or sanding, if you've got a little thing that can be touched up in 2 seconds with the next coat, and you try to fix that, you might just make yourself an extra 20 minutes of work in what you screw up trying to repair a minor imperfection. Now, with music, I have that problem with mixing. I don't like this, I just want to do this and tweak this little thing, and now I just screwed everything up and I have to start over again. With paint and visual art, it's the same way. This one little line that from viewing distance nobody can even see, I've got to fix it to the point where now I'm throwing this piece away. But doing it here, no big deal. I learned to leave well enough alone in a situation that's not so high stakes. The other lesson that's wrapped into this is getting a bird's eye. When you watch the time lapse of me doing all this sanding, you'll notice how often I stand up and get a look from another perspective. And I think, especially with visual art, it's hard to stay out of the hole of the tunnel vision when you're going, and it's hard to remain aware of the fact that no one else is gonna look at it the way you're looking at it. And that they're gonna look at your painting, not here, but they're gonna look at it from back here. They're gonna look at it from here. They're gonna look at it from viewing distance. So getting those other perspectives help you understand what you actually need to do to complete a piece. So if I go and stare at my spackle like this, I could find imperfections all day for the rest of my days to try to tweak out. But if I go here, where people are actually going to look at it from, I can say, okay, I need to address that ripple, and I need to address this lump, and I need to address that hole. And that's it. And that's really, really, really helpful in almost any aspect of life, is getting other perspectives, right? Taking a step outside of your view of it and seeing how other people may look at it, that's usually pretty good. But here is a place to learn it, where if you screw it up, you don't ruin a relationship, you don't ruin a piece of art, you don't ruin something that you have your heart and soul invested into. So if you learn it here, you can apply it to really important things. And so that's my philosophy on why creative people should learn how to finish drywall.
Thank you.
Sanded all the way, got second coat of spackle done all the way, got the final two coats paint on the final two flats, cleaned up the joint a bit, started to put my shelves to use, so pretty good day today, really pleased with the progress, and tomorrow get to put the mask back on and start sanding all over again, but hopefully I can wet sand most of tomorrow and not have to breathe dust all day. That would be great. So thanks for coming by and checking this out, and come back tomorrow to see what's happening.